If we said that Israel is the 51st state of the USA, then we are able to say that the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia is the 52nd state of the USA.
Since that historic meeting that took place 65 years ago between Franklin Delano Roosevelt and His Majesty's father, King Abdulaziz, we have had a strong and strategic relationship between the United States and Saudi Arabia.
America's largest weapons consumer. Active and open deals are valued at $97 billion. In return, the U.S. gets oil worth more than $50 billion a year. In 2013, their mutual trade volume was more than $70 billion. That's the latest available figure. Economic ties set to grow.
The United States and Saudi Arabia have an extraordinary friendship and relationship that dates back to Franklin Roosevelt and Faisal, and we are continuing to build that relationship during a very challenging time.
The only reason we did not successfully arrive and complete our mission from Bandar Abbas to the port of Hodeidah in Yemen, it's only one reason, and that's U.S.-backed Saudi terrorism. Well, if they had blatantly attacked this ship, now we know they were planning to attack the ship when we arrived. They had bombed the port in the hopes that we would be there. You know, there were attempts, but I think if they had done that, if they had attacked the ship, if people on the ship had been injured or killed, that would have completely exposed the Saudis to the entire world. People would have seen them for the truly heartless monsters and agents of Wall Street that they are, because that would have completely exposed them. Agents of Wall Street. The reason that the United States is so happy to align itself with the Saudi regime is because Wall Street oil corporations, ExxonMobil, among others, have a very cozy relationship with the Saudi monarchy and always have. The Saudi regime, just like the Israeli regime, is a base of Western imperialism in the Middle East, doing the bidding of the Wall Street bankers as they seek to try and continue to rule the world and make super profits at the expense of humanity. I want to add this. What Wall Street and the Saudis and the Israelis and all the forces of wealth and power are really afraid of is that Yemen could establish its independence and then, in doing so, begin to utilize the country's vast, untapped oil resources. It's no secret that the country has a vast reserve of oil that has been untapped and not utilized. And they fear that Yemen could become another country like Iran or Venezuela that is using its oil resources to develop its own economy independently in the interest of its own population, not under the control of foreign bankers. And the profits from Yemeni oil could go to the development of Yemeni society. That's what they're very afraid of. There's no evidence as of yet that I've seen that Iran is supporting the Ansar Allah organization, but they're afraid that Yemen could become another Iran, another country that's established its national liberation and independence and begun the course of developing itself freely without the control of the West. And I will say that the risks that I took by getting on that ship are not over. I do have a fear that I could be prosecuted when I return to the United States, because there has been such an attempt in Western media to portray this as a military operation. There could be an attempt to prosecute me when I return to the U.S. The last time I visited Iran, I faced a very harsh interrogation upon returning. Now, this time that I was on the ship, I fear there could be even more serious legal consequences.